about 12, the 17 is around 12:50. Is everything shifting appropriately? So we'll just cruise up this hill, get to where we need to go. Transmission seems to shift just fine when it's warmed up, but in the morning it's still stalling the truck, so I think I need the throttle body clean to get the last bit of the trans fluid out of it. It's climbing this hill a heck of a lot better than it climbed the Mount Lee Monitor. Sorry, not Mount Lee Monitor, the Mount Lee Hill. Side of the lane. I don't get any mud in here either.
This one splashed, and last time it didn't.
We're too high off the ground. Pull him out! Go ahead, attach it!
I know you're going to pull him out.
First pull. That wasn't much at all. That wasn't even hard.
No, it's not. You pulled his truck out.
Yes, with ease.
What do you mean when they say with ease?
Meaning I'm 22,000 pounds and he wasn't even, I don't even think I gave a gas.
Did you see he just pulled himself out?
No, the truck just pulled him out like nothing.
Like it was just
been
here.
We all set? don't know what that pop was.
Yeah, but the little girl was waving at me.
Everybody's watching me. That was so easy.
How much more?
Reserved for the military. At this point, I try to climb the hill. I'm still testing it. I have not engaged the front axle. I see some smoke coming out the side, which is perfectly normal. I do not make it. The back four tires do spin.
Wow.
At this point, I decide to reverse back down the hill. And then I'm like, well, you can't make it in 4x4.
I did not expect to get stuck. So, what we're going to do is we're going to put it in drive.
So I engage the front axle and make a second attempt. See if I can climb this semi-difficult hill. And I make it up without an issue. There is a little bit of dust, but I can expect that. No issues.
That's definitely nobody helping us.
No, I had to engage the front wheel drive. Yeah.
Dust.
Lots of dust. I didn't engage the six-wheel drive. Disengaging six-wheel drive?
And turning to four-wheel drive?
Back to four-wheel drive.
Whoa. What was that?
All kinds of bopping sounds.
But what is it from?
I don't know.
It was still going down. The bed was cracked. Yep. It felt like the bed was cracked.
It did, didn't it? No, we'll check all the... Make sure everything's flexing right. Sure won't break anything. Wow, this is a 4x4 monster, about 6x6 monster.
This is a new camera angle. Tell me if you guys prefer this compared to the windshield mount. I also have an external one coming in. As soon as we get to the appropriate one, I'll cut to that one. And then come back to this one. I'm still going to be experimenting with some new software so I can put in view and out of view. You got to remember, this is the first time out, and my cameraman decided he didn't want to show up today because he had better things to do. We're all kind of panicking right now. These mandates were from the school district and maybe forcing them to be vaccinated. So, with those issues, same thing with me. So, in New York, they're going to just fire everybody in the medical field, bring in the military to replace them. It's kind of called a dictatorship, but they don't seem to have any issues with it. Thank you.
axle's never as strong. You can hear his front axle popping, and it's just not designed this way. If you're going to pull, if you're winched, you stay stationary. If you're going to pull like he's doing, then use your back axle. It's twice as thick as your front. Just word the wise.
Dad, are you going to be dead?
My turn. Right about now, I realize I'm in trouble. The front bumper is starting to plow into the mud because it's not wide enough. So I try to reverse. All four tires are spinning in the rear. Notice I'm in trouble, so I engage the front axle. Now I'm in 6x6, still 6x6 high. During this entire trip, I never went to 4 low. Now I'm plowing the mud. So I straighten out to reduce the resistance, back out, and then I'm like, you know what? I'm just going to go straight. So I back out, clear myself. There was a vehicle that just passed me, and then I decide to go forward. I don't think it's going to be this deep, but as you can see, I start the climb. Left side dips down. I'm on top. I'm feeling great. And then everything starts slipping. Tires off the ground. I almost roll it, recover it, and bring it back. Thank you so much for the film. Once again, the guy in the blue jeep. So first tow, first recovery. So I got it up under there, and that's the linkage that broke. So we got the bar. If it extended, I can go much higher, but everything seemed to work. All right, so first rig set up. I may have to lower him just a little bit so he doesn't rub.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh man, yeah.
So, remember when I went up that hill? I went up that hill right there.
Yeah. Snapped that's it right there. So these go on here. On the bar.
Oh yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. All right. Let's get him out of here. All right, so this is the third attempt. So I got a truck on tow behind there. I don't know if you can see it. There's a Jeep. Yeah. So he broke, yeah.
You good?
Got it. Okay. We're good.
You guys good?
Yeah.
Let me get out of the way first.
He sits back there. Leave your comments below. Hit that subscribe if you like what you see. First test drive, pros, cons, let me know. My hope is that I'll be offering this service for free. If I can get enough subscribers and try to bring in some money, it'll offset the cost of what I paid for this truck, which is about $82,000, just so I can offer help. So thank you very much. Hit the like. I'd say get hooked, but someone else already used that. And thank you very much for any footage you have. Feel free to send it to me. I'll put it on and make a mention. Thank you very much. Hit the subscribe. And, when I hit 2,500, I'm giving away a free 1,900-pound winch. So I'll see you down in the canyon. Talk to you soon. Thanks a lot.